aviation is the most challenging of all of the transport methods that we use. It's hard to beat aviation fuel, which is a low-density material.
If we really want to keep flying, we need to do it with a low-carbon approach, and sustainable aviation fuel is the way to do it.
Sustainable aviation fuel must mean that it's a fuel that drives a plane without the production of carbon. I am Professor Sir David King, formerly Chief Scientific Advisor to the British Government. If we try to see what are the alternatives, one is to produce aviation fuels using non-fossil fuel sources. The way you're going to do that is to create alternative sources of carbon, because aviation fuel is necessarily carbon-based.
I'm Jennifer Holmgren, and I'm the CEO of LanzaTech. LanzaTech has developed a biological process that uses what you would know as traditional fermentation to make all types of products, except that instead of starting with sugar like you do when you make beer or wine, we actually start with waste gases.
My name's Sean Simpson. I'm the Chief Scientific Officer and the founder of LanzaTech. We were able, in the first instance, to make high volumes of ethanol from resources like steel mill waste gases or gases produced from municipal solid waste. That ethanol that we can make from these different waste resources can itself be turned into aviation fuel. In each one of these is a small reactor in which we're feeding gas, and there's microbes in there that eat the gas and turn that gas into ethanol. So really, this is like a microbrewery. So in this reactor, microbes are constantly being fed gases. They're constantly consuming that gas and converting it into a sustainable molecule like ethanol. We can, in a small way, convert our sustainable gases into products continuously, and those products, of course, can be used for making jet fuel, making replacements for gasoline, or making materials that we use in everyday life. We developed the technology based on our understanding of the ability of certain kinds of bacteria to consume gases, particularly carbon dioxide, the classic greenhouse gas, carbon monoxide that turns into carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, and hydrogen. There are microbes that pre-existed most forms of life on Earth that can use these gases to produce valuable molecules. And so we wanted to leverage this ability, this natural process, to allow the production of sustainable materials.
It's making the aviation sector rethink how much feed, how much raw material is available for making sustainable aviation fuel. Some of the feedstocks that have been used have been biological feedstocks that might compete with food if you use too much of it.
The way to produce aviation fuel immediately that's available now is using sugar from sugarcane. But in any case, you are then cutting across food supplies. So there's another problem. We've got a heavily growing global population, now approaching 8 billion.
And so what we're doing is we're saying, look, all of these waste resources that don't compete with food, don't compete for land, don't use water, can be converted to jet fuel.
Sustainable aviation fuel has already been shown to be better. It's better because it has a much lower greenhouse gas footprint. It's better because it has a much lower sulfur emission. It's better because it has a slightly higher energy density, so you don't need so much fuel to travel the same distance.
I think one of the major challenges for the industry is how do you decarbonize while still growing, while still enabling people to take a break?
I think there's no question that aviation in the future is going to look very, very different from where it is now. The question of incentivizing financing for all of this is very heavily dependent on two things. Regulatory process needs to come in to give aircraft a certain amount of carbon dioxide they can emit for a certain journey carrying a certain number of people. You've got to have common standards, but it does require international agreement. You introduce regulations, and these are progressive, so that you keep driving to the next stage. so that we're always pushing the airlines until they are fully sustainable and fit for purpose.
I not only see a future where captured CO2 delivers 100% of sustainable aviation fuel, I see that that future is essential. We have to be on the cusp of a new industrial era. We've commercialized something that no one thought was possible, using bacteria that no one thought could be tamed, at a scale that no one believed that we would achieve. So, am I hopeful? Absolutely.